Hi, this is Kamuna Hart, your science quiz. Today I am going to discuss about chapter 4, reproduction in plants. Now, reproduction. Plant reproduction is the production of new offspring in plants, which can be accomplished by sexual or asexual reproduction. Every organism of the world tends to keep its descendants before it dies. This is a natural phenomenon. The complex process by which an organism produces its offspring is known as reproduction. There are two types of reproduction, sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is a mode of reproduction by which offspring arise from a single parent and inherit the genes of that parent only. It is reproduction which does not involve meiosis fertilization. The offspring will be exact genetic copies of the parent. Asexual production is of two types. One is formation of spores, other is vegetative reproduction. And vegetative reproductions are two types, natural and artificial. What is formation of spores? The tendency of asexual reproduction by spore formation is found mainly in lower graded plants, as for example penicillium. Okay, now how do plants reproduce asexually? There are some key concepts when vegetative reproduction occur: natural and artificial, bulb, tuber, runner, rhizome. Runner is also said stolon. In our textbook, it is said as stolon. And artificial vegetative reproduction is cutting, layering and grafting. But in our textbook, we will discuss about cutting and grafting. And I have told what is layering. Layering is a means of plant propagation in which a portion of an above ground stem grows roots while still attached to the parent plant, and this detaches as an independent plant. Now, natural vegetative reproduction, segmentation through root modification, modified stem. These are the modified stem: tuber, rhizome, bulb, stolon, offset bulbils and from leaves. Now what is segmentation? Segmentation reproduction from segment is called segmentation. Small pieces or segments formed due to decomposition or some other reason. Each segment gives rise to new plant, as for example algae. Now through root. New shoots grow. This is bud, solen root and tuber. And in this root, storage of food also occur. Basically, sagum, teak, bottle, etc. grows through roots. And also, sweet potato is the example of our natural vegetative reproduction. Now, tuber. Natural vegetative reproduction occurs through tuber roots, swollen underground stem bearing a number of scale leaves. This is eyes from where new plant also produced. This is shoots and this is roots. Example of tuber is also potato. Rhizome, that is another modified stem for vegetative propagation. Look at this, new plant is formed and this is scale, this is bud and this is node. The food produced from the photosynthesis passes downward to the plant and here is root. Okay. Now bulb. Modified buds. Buds, a bud contain an underground stem reduced in size. underground stem that is reduced in size. Leaves are swollen with stored food, example onion, daffodil, tulip, and also garlic. Also turmeric, and the main bud will grow into a new shoot. The side bud will also grow into new shoots. Okay, look at the figure. This is the figure of bulb and onion. This is leaf. This is fleshy leaves. This is reduced stem that is found underground. This is root. This is side bud. This is main bud. Okay, now stolon. A stolon is a stem that curves toward the ground and, on reaching a moist spot, takes root and forms upright stem and ultimately a separate branch. Okay, look at the figure. This is a plant and a stem that curves towards the ground, and also this is a moist place and takes the roots and form a separate plant. Okay, this is stolon. This is stolon. These are adventitious roots. Look at this. A stem is developed towards the ground, okay, on a moist spot, and takes roots and also forms an upright stem, and a separate new plant is formed. Now, offset. An offset is a tiny plantlet that develops as a side shoot at the base of a plant. Several can form a clump at the base of a parent plant. Example, aloe vera. Look at the figure. Now, what is bulbing? This is bulbing. The improper development of auxiliary bulbs of some plants form round-shaped structure called bulbil. Here also storage of food occurs. This is leaves and this is stem, and this from this bud does not develop any stem. Okay, and it forms round or ball-shaped structure for the storage of food, and it is also a natural vegetative reproduction organ. Now, from leaves also leaf buds created. For example, in our country, pathirkuchi is the natural vegetative production leaves. From a grounded leaf of a bryophyllum, numerous young bryophyllum grows. Look at the figure. Numerous bryophyllum occur, and this is a leaves. And all the process of vegetative propagation cited above occur naturally. Okay, this is the natural vegetative reproduction or propagation from leaves. Now, artificial vegetative reproduction, that is grafting. What is grafting? Grafting is a technique that joins two plants into one, combining characteristics of both plants. Look at the figure. This is rootstock. This is sipon. Graft union that is wrapped and waxed. And look at the again definition, where both plants' characteristics combine in the grafting process. Grafting is a technique that joins two plants into one, combining characteristics of both plants. Okay. Now, cutting. The most common method are stem cutting, in which a piece of stem is part buried in the soil, including at least one leaf node. The cutting is able to produce new roots, usually at the node. Root cutting, in which a section of root is buried just below the soil surface and produces new shoots. Now look at the figure. This is a plant. Okay, it is cut by a blade where leaves also there, or leaf node is also present there. And now it is put into another pot where there is sand, soil or compost is present, and from here also new shoot will grow. This is a artificial system of vegetative reproduction. Now thank you everybody. Best of luck.